So this hill and that hill we can join with this water harvesting structure, and the all water come that side, so all collect here and recharge underground aquifers, and water go on the wells and they are using for agriculture and for drinking. You can see the visual impact, downstream greenery and grasses and tree and vegetation come up with the moisture. If the moisture come up, the greenery come up, and greenery come up, the prosperity come up. So this is the link with the water, underground aquifer, and surface. Due to this water conservation, our farmers are taking good 2-3 crops. So now the much grains is coming. Now we are giving the grain to the cities. We are giving to the vegetable to the cities. Now the city people coming in my village for the employment. Now more than 7,600 water harvesting structure we construct with the community force, with the community mobilization, with the community strength. Green forest in desert of Rajasthan. When we start this water harvesting structure, they give the notice to me, a legal notice. Under the Irrigation Drainage Act 54, they are saying, you catch the rains here. This rains is not yours. Who is this water? I ask the question. Who is this water? Yours? Government's? No. Water is a natural resource. Water is a common resource. Water is not a property. Water is a resource for the life.
At the point that I learned about Nestle's intention of establishing a bottling plant here in Michigan, I thought, Nestle here in the heart of our state, bottling water, this is a big one. They're pumping upwards of 450 gallons per minute. And what that means in ecological terms is that streams are lowering, that what used to be bodies of water are turning into mud flats, lake levels are dropping in the vicinity of this pumping site. Adding insult to injury is the fact that Nestle Corporation doesn't pay 1 cent for the water that they extract. And they're making, it's speculated, upwards of $1.8 million a day in profits off of that water, which belongs to all of us.
So here we are in Michigan. You got a company that wants to pump water out of a stream system. All right, it doesn't own the water. It has a right to use the water like other landowners. So the question is, does their right to use mean they have a right to put it in a bottle and claim ownership and sell it? That was the basic question.
We asked for a moratorium and said, give the people more time to research this, to find out, is this what the community wants? And the township officials basically said, we know what's best.
When citizens hear about a project, you can be sure the company's been there for at least a year already. They've talked with everybody they need to talk to. They've been given the green light informally.
Nestle Corporation received $10 million in tax abatements over 10 years. So not only are they not paying for the water itself, but they're not even contributing to the local tax base of that community.
And the DNR leased that property to them for 99 years for $63,000. Nothing.
And you see these semi-trucks traveling in, one right after the other, to pick up this water, which has been pumped from the ground. has traveled through 12 miles of stainless steel pipe. They've treated it with chemicals. They've put it in plastic bottles, which are a non-renewable resource. They're polluting our watersheds the moment you've consumed the water.
And I'm sure a lot of it will end up right back up here because they sell Ice Mountain in the area. So it's ludicrous. They make scads of money giving our water back to us.
They're being sued in 5 states. In Zephyr Hills, they took so much water that there are huge sinkholes where the land is sinking. And I live on a farm, and I don't want my little stream to disappear, and they want to put more wells up in Everett.
My wife's sister, when they were doing her testing last year, she ran out of water at that time when they were doing her 7-day test and 4-day test.
And my neighbor next to me is almost out of water, and all of this started after they started testing their wells.
We're fighting this battle, this David and Goliath battle.
We are having to have garage sales and bake sales and concerts and all kinds of little fundraisers.
It's now in session. The Honorable Lawrence C. Root presides. You may be seated.
The UN is saying in their reports, by the year 2020, we're going to have half the world's population without adequate water. By God, they're coming after Michigan's water. When Nestle came into Michigan, they said, we're a good corporate citizen. We're not going to hurt anything. We're responsible. During the trial, the company kept pumping during a season of drought.
Any of the predicted reductions in flow in dead stream will have absolutely no effect on that ecosystem.
The stream area in front of one of the client's homes was basically a mud flat. I cross-examined the plant manager, and I said, look at these pictures, there's a mud flat here. Don't you think you ought to stop pumping? They kept pumping even then.
Some of these small channels that flow into the lake from these springs along the North Shore almost stopped flowing.
The reality was, no matter what they said, there was significant adverse impact, and they kept pumping.
We had a petition drive. And a couple of weeks later, citizens are calling me and saying, someone knocked on my door, and it was a private investigator.
They even hired a